A church that preaches the gospel unapologetically and clearly equates to new converts, but new converts need to be nurtured. In other words, they need to be brought to maturity, which is why we're discipleship driven, that it might lead to a missional mindset. You see, a baby can't lead a family, but there are a lot of babies leading families. My granddaughter, Chloe, can grab my phone and fool you into thinking that she knows what she's doing with my phone. She may even be able to operate it, not proficiently, but she can probably get in there and make some stuff up and send somebody a text message that's really weird. But check this out. The moment that her stomach starts to growl, she aborts mission, drops the phone, she wants her baba. When there are immature babies leading homes, the moment you go through a hardship, you abort mission and you don't know how to lead your family. You drop the mission and you want your baba. Man, I love you. If your hobby is more important to you than your family, you're missing the whole point. It's a lot of y'all that love video games. And the reason why you love these video games is because it thrusts you into a reality that you can control. And you don't want to let go of control because you got control issues. And so you stay stuck in that virtual reality instead of embracing the reality that God gave you to lead your family. That hobby is a little more important to you than your family. And you can feel anybody, and just, I'm not talking about just gamers. Maybe it's fishing, maybe it's golf, maybe it's football. You name it. If that's more important to you than you leading your family, willing to lay down your life to show your family how much you love them and want to lead them, then Houston, we've got ourselves a problem. But when a church, a mature church that says we're discipleship driven, is raising up solid men by way of, praise God for Dominic Sasso, men's ministry, praise God for Myrna and her team, a solid women's ministry, praise God for Daryl Bird and his team, a solid marriage ministry, praise God for Trey and his team, Raisa and them, a youth ministry, praise God for Debbie and her team back there, a solid kids ministry. It starts from the kids where we're laying a foundation for their faith, and then it goes into youth where they're actually showing them practical tools on what it means to become young men and stopping the school to prison pipeline, and then we send them on to men's and women's ministry that they might actually learn of God, and then we bring them here on Wednesdays that we dig deeper into the Lord and we dig deeper into scriptures, and then we have marriage ministries that help shape the marriage. See, when a church does that, that's when men learn how to lead and wives learn how to love. And then it reignites the family structure. And then the family structure, then watch this, and then in turn actually serves and blesses the church. Don't think it's a coincidence that when Jesus said in Ephesians 4 that he's building up the church, right after that, in Ephesians 5, he said, and now go serve the family.